Oops. Yeah, I need a few extra minutes to compose myself there. Tiredness is starting to set in a little bit. Into several phases. One, movement. Two, searching the room. Free pump. If any, there you go. Okay. So move. Characters, move one room at a time. Move one room at a time. I think I wrote about this article. Each time, player searches the room, decrease the loot value of that room by one. The loot value, which is 0. That room can no longer be searched. We'll see. Table entry. I'm gonna put this at the bottom because it makes more sense there. Inside a room. Player may. Ooh. Player may search the room. Inside. Once per turn, once per round, player may search the room their character is in. To search, roll two dice. Table's being weird. Dice roll. What is bound? Old, old, and old. So, minimum impossible is 2. Four. Wait. Okay. So I want 2 to 12. 2 to 12 is 10 values. No. 11 values. So I want half of those values to be 0. That means 6 values. So anything below a 7 is nothing is found. Eight, 9, 10, 11, 12. Well, I guess we could say 8, 9, 10 to 11, and 12. Is found. Find piece of gear. I really want to make 12 just straight up like find some technology. I feel like that would be really difficult though. But maybe not. I I mean, maybe there should be 2 to 6, 7 to 9, 10 to 11. Find a piece of technology. Technology. Discover. Crap. Yeah, I'll leave it like that. Okay. When you enter, that means that this becomes room, as well as any enemies attack. I think traps should trigger when you exit a room. Enemies attack. Enter. Then that does make sense. Scrounge in. Simplified image. May choose to search. The body instead They're searching the room, actually. Deceased player may then grab a sheet. I think. And create a new game. Start from the again. And they may copy the content of the global map onto the big one. Okay, so it's now 9:30. So I'm just gonna do the roundup for the show, couple last words of business, and then I'm gonna call it a night. I will keep working on this though, because it's nearly finished. It's nearly at a spot where I would consider it a playable draft. It's not gonna be a good playable draft, but it will be a playable draft. But like I said, I'm gonna keep working on it. I think there's something there that can be polished into something good. So yeah, closing out words of business. All right, accidental lookup. So I kept reading Sid Field this week. This will be the last week I read Sid Field. I didn't quite finish it, but I'm tired of talking about it on here. So no more Sid Field. The stuff I read this week was actually really cool. There's a lot of stuff about endings, about life, Sid Field's life journey, that really that forced some contemplation on my part, in terms of my own life, which is always a good thing. So yeah, I still feel that book seems kind of dated. And I've talked with a few people, and I'm thinking about doing some like 200 to 500 word reviews of the books we've done in book club, and maybe some other stuff as well. And putting them up on the website for people to look at. So yeah, I say especially because any good review, or the reviews that I like to read, tend to be reviews in context. What does this say about the canon of work that it fits in, which not a lot of reviews do. So I think if I do them, that'll be the focus, will be context. So yeah, gonna be probably writing about writing, as it were. But yeah, I still feel as it feels a little dated. Maybe it's just the edition I have, because it's been updated a few times. But for me, there's some really good foundations there, underneath that sort of dated film style. So yeah, and I'll break that down a little bit more in the show notes and in the reviews, as it were. Next week, we are going to be doing, where did I put it? Right. Next week, we are going to be doing this guy. Oh, I should do a big screen. Next week, we're going to be doing this guy, writing science fiction and fantasy. It's a collection of essays and other things about writing fantastical settings, speculative fiction. I've read part of this book before. This is actually a new one I just bought last week, because I know how relevant it will be to the stuff we're going to be doing. And I've read a few of the essays that are in it, but not the entirety of the book. So yeah, we're going to be doing this guy. I know a few episodes ago I said I was going to be doing the H.P. Lovecraft thing, and I still want to do that, but I feel like right now I should be hitting things that are really relevant to the stuff that we're working on. It literally helps with the things that we're doing at the moment. Other than that, any other pressing business? I don't think so. I'll be posting the VODs on the website tomorrow, as well as doing some updated show notes. I didn't do any show notes for the last episode because it was completely unprepared, just as well as this one. But tomorrow, on Monday, I'm going to be writing down... I'm going to watch both the VODs, and I'm going to write down sort of the stuff I talked about. Boil it down into something relevant and post both of those by Tuesday at the latest. I promise. Other than that, I think that's everything. Reviews, book club, show notes. Yeah. I think that's it. So, like always, I'll be posting all this stuff to the website. Go over there, head over there. You'll see the thing right down that way. Right down there. Check out the website, show notes, as well as links and references to things that I think are interesting or relevant to the topic that we discuss week to week. This has been Accidental Origin. Thanks for joining me. My name is Brendan. I do this every week, Sunday, 7 p.m. Eastern, and I will probably be doing another Wednesday stream. I'm not sure what it's going to be on. But Sundays at 7, Accidental Origin, weekly writing web show. Thanks for hanging out. Bye.